We welcome you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.
For joining us. Manoj, sir, for the presentation, and you will take the session. Okay, sir?
Yeah, my voice is audible.
Yes, sir.
Okay, ma'am. Please go through presentation.
Okay, sir.
And good morning to all. Actually, my video is not working. So presentation is also in hand with our manager. So we will just proceed through. And today my session is basically the food processing sector. And if you see, our some of the 70% of the population of India is mainly dependent on agriculture and food processing. And if you see the food grain production at all India level, it is very close to 245 million. Ma'am, please make the full screen.
Okay, sir.
So we have a lot of production of the food at 245 million ton. But the food processing industry was growing at only 13% growth rate. Although we have a lot of opportunities in this sector, but the growth rate is very low. This is up to the 13%. This is pre-COVID periods. So if you see the condition of December 2019, for the most of the Indian economy, the growth of this industry is crucial for the overall growth of the nations. And since large population is dependent on the agriculture and agriculture development, so this industry is very much linked to the food, to the Indian economy. If you see our this processing of fruit and vegetable, there are so many sectors in processing, but if you see the fruit and vegetable sector, it is very low. It is only 12%. And while the developed countries process over 80%. So you can see the gap of our processing conditions and the other countries, developed countries processing. So this is the better time, and this is the appropriate time, because if you see the COVID-19, everyone watching for the vaccine, there is no medical facility, no proper vaccine. Only everyone recommending about the food, and everyone just very fear of the food, that our food is either contaminated with the virus and other things. So these all problems are very much related to this industry. So our topic is food sector. What is the current status, challenges and opportunities in entrepreneurship developments? Next, ma'am. Please, next. So if you see, we are most of the cases we are either first position or then second position, and depend upon the different agroclimatic zones. And if you see the second largest arable land in our country, largest irrigated land, largest producer of wheat, pulse and milk, largest producer of exporter of spices, second largest producer of tea, rice, fruit, vegetable, means everywhere in most of our agriculture sector we are the first, second or third. So this, if you can see, this is the scenario. Although we have all things, but our processing is not going very fast. Next. And please, next. If you see why this food processing sector is very important for the this processing sector for the nation's growth, because food, if you see the food processing is the transformation of raw ingredient by physical and chemical means to valuable foods or edible foods in different format. So this food processing combines some raw food ingredient to produce marketable food products and can be easily prepared and served by the consumer. Exactly, this is the conditions why everyone is just waiting for the packed food in this COVID-19 period. And every time if you process, if you minimize, if you remove, and if you add the value addition in the food in different formats, it will be very much useful for the society. So this food processing is the important aspect in the food processing sector. Next, ma'am. Please, next. So if you see, this is the industry segment. May please come to the previous, ma'am. Industry said after that. Before, please, ma'am. Before these slides. Okay. And this. Please go to the third slide, ma'am. So everywhere this this industry segment. Industry, if you see the industry segment, it's very important and important. If you see the scenario of the key segments, where fruit and vegetable, dairy, meat, marine, poultry, these all aspects are very less utilized in processing. In fruit and vegetable, very less processing is doing or is converting into valuable product. Highest is the dairy. Meat is also up to some level, marine and poultry. So we have need to process all in these sectors. Next. So why this food processed? What is the need of food process? If you see the food processor, food processes affect our raw ingredient and our composition of ingredient, food ingredient in different way. If our food has some toxins, it can be removed or minimized that food processing. It will be made very easy to transportation by just decreasing their some harmful aspect and increasing their shelf life. And also they decrease the volumes. So this food processing is very much suit for the lifestyles. It can be add some extra nutrient. Most of the cases, they although have one type of nutrient, but we can add the other nutrient, which is important for the their useful. So if you see the overall scenario, this food processing play a very major role in different aspects of this food sector. Next. Next. Ma'am, please, next. Okay, if you see, this is the some geographical classification of our country. Metros, at least eight metros are there. 32 major cities are there. 404 towns are there. Small towns are there and village towns are there. Actually, why we are asking about this? Because this majority of the cities, they mainly depend upon the packed food. And this packed food consumption is due to the food processing. So if you concentrate only on these metro and other cities, you can imagine the scope and of the food processing sector. So everywhere, everyone is at least depending on some aspect to the packed food. That's why food processing in different aspects is very important for the controlling the economy of our country. Next, ma'am. If you see why food processing, and because our country is very much concerned to their foods. The food habit in each region vary with climate, topography, culture and heritage. So this food sector, specifically food processing sector, is very important. Because in case of India, is thus a very culturally rich, diverse nation, having varied lifestyles, religions, art, culture, art and food. If you see the different regions of the country, of the states, have different food style. That's why this food processing sector has a very major scope, and it can be enhance the food industry to different way. Next, man. Next, please. So if you see this, why this diversity of food in India is very much important in our country, in the food processing sector, because we have everyone in the in our country have very much patience to the food. They have their own like and dislike to the foods. The meal times are considered as an occasion and times for the families to get together and spend quality time. In all these situations, either the some functional situation or some individual situation, everyone just prefer the some their own interest of food. If you see the typical Indian meal, they are basically made up of the appetizers, main course, and some other sweets thing. And these are the some composition. This is the basic composition of our country food. So you can imagine everywhere this food is very important. And how can we reach the person's home by using this food processing? This is again challenging. Next. If you see, if you ask the different region-wise the food habits, if you see the North region, which basically include Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, Haryana, Punjab, Himachal Pradesh, Jammu and Kashmir, these are mainly based on the wheat breads. And these wheat profile are very important. A fair amount of cooking is done using deep frying. But the deep frying is habitat is very much like, and highly consumption of milk and milk-based product. If you see the consumption of fresh food such as apples, cherry, these all are very much concerned to the regional food habit of North region. So if you concern to the this food and develop the packed food on that basis, it will be very much successful in the North region. Next, ma'am. Next, please. If you come to the South India region, this food habits, mostly including Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Goa, Tamil Nadu and Kerala, the primary vegetarian population in this region is basically fish and staple diets. Rice is abundant and appears in almost every dishes during the meal are eaten in multiple farm. Tamarind and coconut farm is very much predominant. Mostly in this region, the people eat and banana and banana leaf. That's why if you see this region, if this select this food habit in the farm of our food processing and adopt all these things in different way for the developing different types of food, for formulating different types of food which have the ingredient of such type, it will be very much successful in this region. Next. If you go to the western region, Rajasthan, Gujarat, Maharashtra, they have very high demand of dairy products, including yogurt, buttermilk, cow milk. And rice is again the staple food grain in that region. If you see the Gujarati cuisines is largely vegetarian. Peanut and coconuts are widely used. Means these are the very much important in this region. So the processing and development and formulation of using this ingredient is, will be very much useful in the food processing sector for this region. Next. Next, if you go, come to the eastern region where Odisha, Bihar, West Bengal and other regions just included, they are relatively more simplistic and less elaborated foods, characterized by a variety of different types of rice, and they mostly eating the fish eating population, and some curries and with different spices are very important. So the selection of this ingredient and formulation according to this will be successful in this region. Next. So the one thing why this trends in consumer preference are very much important in food processing and why this trend is very much predominant in food. If you see the growing food class population and household incomes in our countries are driving people to spend more on food. Most of the people are their health conscious, some of the people are the taste conscious. So by using this interest of the people, we can utilize in the food processing sector. If you see, the increasing cases of lifestyle diseases have resulted in the shift healthier food option. Everyone want and that our food will fulfill the preference of medicine. So if make our food healthy or we make health food, it will be very much important. Like nowadays, the most of the fruit juices with the antioxidant, probiotic foods and other multi-fibers and multi-nutritional foods are available in the market. These are again one of the consideration for the this food processing, because we have consumption preference and increasing demand, both are the driving the food companies to introduce the some innovative products such as digestive biscuits, fortified dairy products. If you see, there are so many nutritional and nutraceutical food products available in the market, and these basically this comes to the trends of consumer preference. So increased demand for the processed and packed food because of the high shelf life. This is again one of the reason why people are preferring the food processing foods. So pay a premium and value-added products like cheese, butter, flavor. Everyone want to just want to a value-added product in the market. Either they pay some extra amount. So this is the some of the reasons why trends of consumers' preference just shifted to the food processing industry. Next month. If you see, these are the some key market and food preference. Why food processing are the in case of West, the biggest market for candy and confectionery. Means if you concentrate on the candy and confectionery and some fruit-based flavor, specifically strawberry and orange, it will be very much essential, it will be very much useful in the food industry for this West region. Next. If you come to the North region, and which is the second most important market of our country, and they are mostly led by the wholesaler, but large volume of sales through a great channel. Large number of modern trade foods and grocery outlets are there. So here food preference is basically food wheat based product. This is the food processing status of the North. Next, ma'am, if you come to the South, in case of South, the food preference is basically chocolate and bakery products like items. And highest incidence of diabetic population in India, leading to consumers' awareness about healthy breakfast choice. So the food processing industry are just growing in the form of the some breakfast, lunch in the form of ready to eat or ready to cook foods. So this food preference is very much useful in the South where the modern penetration of modern trades are mostly our consumers' awareness, and this preference selected by the food industry will be helpful in the south region. Next, east region. Again, in this region, the most food preference are the non-oily and less spicy food products. So, this is our key point for the east key markets. And beef and pork products are also heavily consumed. So, if you develop the food or concentrate on the shelf life, formulations, packaging aspect of this will be useful in the east region. Next, ma'am. So, why this is important? If you see, the distribution is very important in the food processing sector. And most of the places, the people are not received properly the food process sector. So, if you see the retail formats, there are three formats: a modern format, traditional format, and institutional format. And we are just selling these products in modern format by supermarkets, by hypermart, and some convenience stores, food government store, and petrol convenience store. If you come to the traditional format, our neighborhood general stores and bakery shops are the mostly useful in this product distribution.
Achana, please, class ke opening ke baad call karenge.
And if you see the institutional
level, aapke paas smartphone hai na, wahan se Google Meet download karo to phone pe bhi aap class attend kar sakte
ho. Yeah, yeah, ma'am. If institutions level, railway airlines are playing very much the distribution units, hotel, restaurant, and catering. Means these all are the very important format nowadays, which we are adopting for the distribution of the food products. Next, ma'am. Next, please, next. So, why this food processing demand driver? What are the different factors which demanding the food processing drivers? Means one important is increasing spending on the food products. People have enough amount to spend. Their whole health products, growing nuclear family and working women's, rising demand for the functional food. So nowadays the functional food sector are very much important in food processing sector. Increasing modern trade format and private travel, changing demographic, rise in disposable income, and one of the important factor, increasing urbanization, life style and aspirations. So these all are the food processing demand drivers nowadays. Next. So market size of functional food. That's why if it just come to the some important segment of the this food processing, which is the functional foods. If you see the this functional food market in our Indian countries, approximately 2% of this Indian market expected to the where higher growth in 2020. So we are expecting a very high growth up 2020 in this functional foods. Functional food in India is one of the rapid growing market in specific region. If you see the functional food, these functional foods are basically those foods which have some other function, some health related function instead of their nutritional function. So this sector, functional food sectors, are very much predominating for the health food and the health consciousness of the people, because the awareness of the about the health, fitness and aging population, that's why these functional foods are very much predominant nowadays. Next. If you see, these are the some functional food markets in the food processing are the vitamins, prebiotic and probiotics, mineral rich, fatty acids, dietary fiber rich and carotenoid, and these are the markets. So we are expecting a very high market in food processing industry up to the 2024. So you can imagine the scope of this functional foods in food processing sector. Next, ma'am. Next, please. So if you come to the food functional food in food processing, basically they are categorized in three types of foods, and some are the basic foods, processed food with the added biotic compound, and food enhanced to have more of a biotic compound. In basic foods, the food or food product which naturally contain the biotic compounds, means we are not adding or removing anything. Like we have already known, the carrots have some their biological and medicinal roles. Because of the beta carotene, oat bran cereals have some beta glucan. Means they are naturally present. So these are the basic foods in the functional food category. In case of processed food with added bioactive compound, where this biotic does not exist naturally in the food, and we are adding through processing. Means during formulations, we are added some biotic compounds, and they are categorized in this second category. Like some of the orange juice with added calcium, some of the other juice with the high antioxidant. some milk available in the market with added omega 3 fatty acids. So this is the second category. In third category, where the foods have already biotic compound naturally, but their level is low, so we can add or modified or concentrate these biotic compounds by adding this at the either their genetic levels, either their production level, either their processing level. For example, yogurt have already probiotic, but we are already increasing the their probiotic characteristic. Tomato have lycopene, but we are increasing the lycopene because these compounds are abiotic compounds, and these compounds play a major role in their health value. So these foods are not only important for the nutrition, they are very much important for the health and nutraceutical property. Next. So if you come to the food processing sector, functional food sector, these are the very important sector. If you go to the any food mall, you see, you can imagine a variety of food products are available. And this variety of food product in the this mall is only due to the very great amount of food processing in the mostly in the functional food sectors industry. If you see the food functional food industry, we have already developed food with added biotic compound, where we added some biologically active compound and improve their quality. Like the in the market, milk with omega 3 fatty acid is available. Second sector, food with enriched biotic compound. We have already discussed yogurt with the increased amount of this probiotic. So these are the some products available in the market in functional food in food processing sector. Next. Next, ma'am, please. Next. So if you see the second sector, nowadays eggs and dairy are just improved. Means the eggs with omega-3 fatty acids are available, cheese with probiotics are available, yogurt product with added antioxidant prebiotics and probiotics are available. So these are the products which are available in the market due to the strong food processing. Next. And if you see the in grain sector, the pasta, one of the important products available in the market, which have not their own properties, which have also added the some dietary fibers for their health enrichments. Some cereals with omega-3 fatty acid and dietary fibers and prebiotics are available. If you see omega-3, dietary fiber, prebiotics, these all are the very important food ingredients, functional food component, which is added for their health value. So these all foods with added values are available in the market. Next, ma'am. Next, please. So if you come to the beverage sector, most of the fruit of the vegetable and fruit juices are available in the market, which have a high amount of antioxidant dietary fiber. These are again one of the important ingredient added in the market. Soya milk is available, which have already their functional property and nutraceutical property. We are also fortified with the omega-3 fatty acids. Some milk product available in the market with the fortified omega-3 fatty acids. So these are the food processing sector and in the functional foods, where they just increase the value and value addition in the form of their health as well as nutraceutical. Next. Next, please. If you come to the snack sector, there are several cookies available in the markets and big malls where they have rich in dietary fiber, omega-3 fatty acids. Some granulara bars and energy bars are available in the market, which are enriched with the omega-3 fatty acid and dietary fiber. So if you see these products are all available in the market, and they're superior to the existing market because of the adding this bio active compound. So this is the actual significance of food processing in the food sector. Next. Please, next. Next, ma'am. If you see the condiment, means here our purpose is to see this slide, because in every sectors, juices, condiment, spices, grain and beverage, in dairy industry, everywhere these food processing are playing very important role, where they just add some biotic compounds, formulate the food products, which is not only the nutritional value as well as the health value. So these are the some example of that particular development, like margarine with the omega-3 fatty is very good product available in the market. Its added phytoestrogen is also available in the market. Some salad dressing with the omega-3 fatty acids, they also available in the market, with some prebiotics are also available in the market. If you can see this different product photograph, these all are the available in the market. It is only possible due to the formulations and the food processing sector. Next, ma'am. So nowadays there are several food component in food industry which is concentrated on the functional component, and that functional components are basic functional component. Means our formulations of the food processing products is dependent upon, our claim is dependent upon some of the natural component found in the either from the fruit, either from the vegetable, either from the grain. So if you can see the some functional food like fortified margarine, they just use the plant sterol and other factor and make the food product. They are very important, and they have already proved the health claim for the reduced total and LDL cholesterol. I mean, this is the functional food which is have the reduced total and LDL cholesterol. One functional food psyllium, other is soya, because they have already the important biological compound. In case of psyllium, the soluble fibers are there. In case of soya, protein is there, and they all are already proved with their health claim. So if any food we formulate by using this functional ingredient is very much useful for the functionality of that particular product. So everywhere these functional foods are very important. Next, ma'am. Next is like cranberry, fatty acid, garlic, green juice. If you see, these all are the natural products, but they have enriched with the biotic component. Means if you formulating properly, if you process this compound and formulate the products, they have the health value. Means if you use cranberry juice, they reduce UTI. If you use fatty fish, they reduce triglycerides, reduce heart disease. If you use garlic, processed garlic compounds in the food, they have organosulfur compounds, and that will be responsible for the reduction of total and LDL cholesterol. Green tea is again very important due to the catechin. If you use this functional component by using proper process where their functionality is retained, definitely the product will be very much useful to reduce risk of various types of cancer. So all are the very much important. All are the very natural important component, and processing is very important, because if these products have the functional component at natural form, but what will be the status as final form? So this processing become a suitable bridge for natural to the final products. If processing is not suitable, then either the compound, either these products have their all the medicinal value, but your final product will not have the functional value. So this processing is very important. Next, ma'am. Next, please. These are again one of the functional food component which are the very important, like spinach, collard, collard. They have lutein and zeaxanthin, and their health value is already reported. They are responsible for reduced risk and AMD. Tomato and processed, they have the lycopene. If you concentrate high amount of lycopene ingredient, and reduce the risk of prostate cancer. Cruciferous vegetable, fermented dairy, means here the processing is very important. Although all these products is very much rich in the nutraceuticals or functional component at ground level, at field level, at market level, but when you not properly process, your final product in your kitchen is not healthy. That's why this food processing aspect is very much important. Next, ma'am. Next, please. So why we concentrated on the this food processing. If you see, during this COVID-19, most of our the economic structure is destroyed, and most of the people's before 1 month are just at home. So everywhere the problem is there, but the problem of economy, the problem of the disease is very much important and very much predominant in our society. Everyone know we have no any options, we have no vaccines. We are only one and two options to the either taking mask or social distancing and washing properly our hand. But if you see, our health ministry and AYUSH ministry as well as WHO recommended one thing: if our immunity is high, if our processed products have higher immunity compound, we will can survive and we can protect our body against this COVID-19. So this COVID-19, our functional foods are very important, because most of the functional food component has strong immune boosting property. If your immunity is strong, and then this COVID-19 virus will be very less susceptible, means your body will be more and more resistant. So this functional food or food processing, a processed food option in the form of higher immunity is very much important. So if you see, these are the some functional foods and where they are very much responsible of the body defense by strengthening immune system. And if our immune system is strong, definitely this will be the best strategy for the avoiding, our best strategy for the protecting ourselves against this COVID and any virus. So these are the some key ingredients in the market where high fiber rich foods, probiotics, fruits, phytochemicals, soya based ingredient, omega 3 fatty acids, vitamins and minerals all have the very diversified roles. And they, although they have the several role, but this immunity boosting properties very much predominant. Next, ma'am. Next, if you see, these are the some foods which the food processing sector is also concentrated, like your dry fruit, curds, sweet potato, tomato, papaya, whole grain, beans. Because of the processing, if you properly process this this food product in the better formulated products, where we just try to retain most of their functional component, it will be very much useful for the immune boosting and immune health against COVID-19. Next, man. Basically, our food processing, now a time our food processing, most of the food processing sector is concentrated to the some of the developing of the foods or developing of the food products with the immune boosting. If you see, these are the some food ingredients nowadays which have already established and proved that they have a very strong immune boosting property, like probiotics. They modulate the immune system, elevate intestinal inflammation. Micronutrient selenium, because this micronutrient for selenium, they have also play important immune stimulant. Means if your food containing selenium, they definitely enhance the proliferation of T cells, and these T cells are very much important role in the COVID-19 protection. Like vitamin A, C, E, everywhere if you see, they are very much responsible. If the food or food processing sector which concerning on these, definitely the food product prevent damage to the immune cells. Vitamin A, C is this neutralize reactive oxygen species, improve immune function. If you see everywhere, all these components are have a very important role in their immune boosting. So if food component have along with this food component, definitely it will be very much useful in this video. Next.
Sir, sorry to interrupt you, but your entire screen is not visible.
Actually, I am not controlling the screen. The screen is controlling by host.
Majid sir, can you please look into it? The entire screen of the presentation is not visible to us.
Yeah, I'm also facing some problem because some of thing is not visualized. So if you can go to the full screen mode.
Sir, the previous slide in which the functions of vitamin A, C and E were given, you could not see the...
Yeah. If you just slide so mode.
Okay, is this fine now?
No, ma'am. This is not slide so, ma'am. I think previous was fine.
Previous one was, but that in that mode, your slides are, sir, bit larger in size. That's why. In slide two mode, they are not visible.
Actually, so please go in that mode because this is very little. This is very small fonts looking here.
Would it be possible for you to share the presentation after the session?
Sure, I will do this.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, just mail me your IDs. I will. We have your email IDs. We will send you.
Yeah, ma'am, please go to the slide mode.
Okay, so just give me 1 minute. Ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. So if you see, these food ingredients are already established. And I can also share one of my papers, which is published on 10th October in Nature. Are basically concentrated on the COVID-19 factors. So if any participant is interested, and I will share that paper, which is recently published yesterday, which is basically the food processing, food functional food component as and the COVID-19. Okay, next, ma'am. So these are the some component. These are the example of that previous ones. If you see the probiotics, there are several probiotic products are available in the market. These are the selenium compounds and their sources. And these are the vitamin A, vitamin C. Means these all are very much important and very much concerned to the COVID-19. Next, ma'am. So if you see the next segment, flavonoids. These flavonoids are again very much important and modulate our immune system, which is already proved because of the high antioxidant, high anti-inflammation. Carotenoids are again very important because they regulate immune function in the and also act as antioxidant, and they also affect the gene regulations. Means they have some factor to the regulating genes. Although in the maturating of these immune cells and the functioning of these immune cells, some of the herbs are very important which stimulate the immune response. Whatever we are just seeing here, all are the very important. And if you see, each and every component are related to the immune, either in the form of immune function, either in the form of modulation of immune system, either the synthesis of immune cells, either controlling of cells. So it are most of the current food processing sector. That's why just concentrating on the formulating such types of food products. Next, ma'am. Next. So this is again example of that our carotenoids, our flavonoids and other, which are the available in the market. And these are the some sources of the these compounds. If you can use these sources in proper process manner, this will be helpful to avoid your corona things. Next. And these are the some naturally immune boosting foods that have been reported in scientific literature, which is already reported. And we have also reported this compound like apple. This apple have a very strong anti-inflammatory function in property, and that's why they manage inflammations. Blackberry, anti-inflammatory, anti-proliferative. Black currant, anti-inflammatory. Means if you see these all, and these examples are very much foods, either in the sectors of vegetable and fruit, but they are very much useful in our immune boosting foods category. Next, ma'am. Cherries are important. Coca is important, cranberry is important, grapes is important, pomegranate is important, and raspberry is important. If you see everywhere, they have very strong immune stimulating property and other property also. If you see this vegetable sector, broccoli, carrot, mango, spinach, sweet potato, every have immune, antioxidant, immunoglobulin, antioxidant property, antioxidant. Means this antioxidant property are again a very much important our body to avoid the some harmful compounds, some toxic compound, and some microbial compounds. So if our food components, if our processed food products have proper processed conditions of this natural ingredient, definitely it will be a very much helpful to the this COVID-19. That's why nowadays currently most of the food processing sectors are concerning to this natural component for formulating some functional food as well as nutraceutical food as well as combined health food for the society. Next, ma'am. Okay, so in concluding, if you see the functional food, some protein, some vitamin A, some zinc, vitamin D, vitamin C with a different source are very much important, and every sector, everywhere WHO, IOs, and everywhere where health is important, they are recommending, because we have no vaccines, we have not proper medical facility, but we have the food option. So if our food have properly processed this compound, it will be definitely help in immune system boosting and definitely helpful to the COVID-19 conditions. Next, ma'am. Please, next. Actually, there are some benefits of this self-presentation and optional presentation. This PPT is not under my control. Okay. So if you come to the one small sectors of the processing, that is the microbial based product, which is, this sector is not, and please previous. And this sector is not only concerned to the dairy. There are several microbial based food products are available. Microbial food products are available in the markets, like probiotic food products. This previous, please, previous. and 43 slide, slide number 43, ma'am, please. Okay, ma'am. So this, if you see, these are the some microbiological based. Nowadays, most of our foods are become the probiotic because it is also established. If any processing industry, if any foods which have the probiotic characteristic are very much useful to maintain our immune system. So these are food ingredients available in the market are mostly prepared with the help of some useful microbes, that is the probiotics, and they have a very enough health aspect. Not only their health aspect is not only related to the immune system, but so many of the other system is also controlled. So this bifidobacterium strains, bifidobacterium infantis, if you see yogurt, sour milk, other milk, fermented milk, these all options are available in the market, and they have basically predominantly are the huge market in our Indian scenario, and they have a very strong health benefits. So the use of probiotics in food processing sector, in food fermentation sector nowadays become the boom, not only for the economy, it will be definitely helpful for our health as well as immune boosting foods. Next, man. Next. If you see this slides, why this microbial, why this probiotics is food, why your yogurt is very important, why your curd and dahi is very important, because these are our inbuilt part of our body. They are God gifted microorganisms which receive during the birth. Means these are microbial. Everyone, doctor, if you go to the doctor, doctor always asks, if your gut is healthy, you are healthy. Means if you want to maintain healthy gut, these microbes are very important. So these are the useful microbes. Microbes comes from the foods, with the foods or other sources, go to our guts and colonized, and finally they just secreted so many of things, and that these molecules are very much important in our health problem, removing the health problem, and one of the major their effect on the immunity. If you see, basically not these probiotics are not only present in our gut, they are also found outside the gut. So these in gut, they harvest energy from the foods, improve gut motility function, reduce the gut barriers, protect against pathogen. If any pathogen comes in inside our gut, they just try to remove as a competency. So outside the of the gut, they mostly bluster up the immune system, push the immune system, like brain, liver, kidney, skin, and vaginal tract. They all have this important probiotic foods. So how this can keep our body healthy? Basically, most of the things, most of the day, we are just taking antibiotics. These antibiotics are basically bad effect on this probiotic or microbial effect. So we should take continuous probiotic and prebiotic products. Prebiotic products are those products which support the growth of this micro. Means these are the supplement on which this probiotic growth. Or you can ask the your growth. So if you see, there are several diseases which is controlled by this, like healthy weights, diabetes. Most of the things are the reported nowadays, your weight management, which is controlling by this gut microbe. If our gut microbes is not properly, we face several diseases, like we can suffer diabetes, some bacterial infections, some metabolic syndrome, several allergy. Means these are the very important. Why this microbiome is very important during this COVID-19? If you see the food everywhere, everyone is just concentrating on their immune booster. If our body is highly immune, definitely we are very healthy against this COVID. This microbiome, these probiotics, they basically involve in the proper maturation and maintenance of immune tissue. If you see, this immune tissue are the responsible for the destroyed and detect and removal of pathogens. And this control and maintain the immune homeostasis, produces several immune cells, molecules like butyric acid, antimicrobial peptides, key signaling molecule, and naturally antibiotics. Definitely these are the very much useful in our health. And they also prevent several diseases which is caused by the pathogenic bacteria. So you can just imagine the role of these probiotics in currently food processing sector. Means this food processing sector, the role of this probiotic based food are very important. Next. If you see, these are the some confusion, mostly people very confused, probiotic and prebiotic. Actually, probiotics are the microbial part and prebiotics are the mostly the substrate part. If you see, these are the different source of the probiotics, like natto, coconut tea, sauerkraut, temp. We can take different form of the probiotics in the dairy, non-dairy, fruit. So these are the probiotic products. And if you see the prebiotics, these are the plant-based probiotic products. Means if your bacteria is there and if you are continuous taking prebiotics, definitely that will be helpful to maintain and proliferation. Next, ma'am, please. So functional food category, mostly in food processing sector, have this of the category. One category is better for you, means they are very much important for you. Food intolerance, these are the examples in the market. Fortified and functional foods, means some foods we are just fortified, and these are there available in Indian market. Naturally foods and organic foods, means our country and Indian markets have a huge amount of food processing in the form of functional food category in different. So you can just take, if you see, there are several examples and several, there are several markets in our Indian scenario which are mainly concerned to the this food industry. Miss Nestle, Britannia, Cadbury, Lupin Tree, Femnica, these all are the big big and major markets in the our India scenario. Next. Okay, so if you see there are some functional food Indian market, very important, which are the major player in the market. If you see the company Amul, Nestle, PepsiCo, Britannia, they are the very much concentrated in some core. Means Amul is mainly concentrated in the dairy sectors. Nestle is concentrated in dairy and food sector. PepsiCo in mostly food sector. Britannica in dairy and food sector. And there are several food products available in the with the Amul, like energy drink, fortified yogurt and drink, health drinks, frozen ice. And these are the some example like Stamina, Nutramil, Prolilite, Flavio. If you see in the market, these brand names are available in the market. So these are the some functional food products. Nestle also is very much predominant in dairy and foods. Yogurt and drinks are the, especially in probiotics, are concerning with the Nestle. Infant foods are also very much concerned with the Nestle. Noodles. So these are the some examples of this food company, like PepsiCo. PepsiCo is very much concerned to the cereal, breakfast, like food products, snack food products, energy drink. And these are the some examples. Britannia, again, they are very much concentrated to the energy drink, fortified, and some snacks like items. So these are the important major food company in the food processing sector. Next, if you see Dabur, Perfecti Milai, Yakult, so Patanjali, Godrej, Hershey, everywhere, these food processing parameters and food processing are very much involved. So diet, if you very well known of food company Dabur, they are mostly concerned to the food wellness. Perfecti Brand, Confectionery, Yogurt, Danone Food. If you see the Dabur are thus producing several Ayurvedic products in the form of functional food like Chyawanprash. So some of them are directly related to our immune system nowadays. Yakult, the food, everyone know the Yakult probiotic product, drinks in the probiotic. They are very much predominant food product in the market. So, and basically in the probiotic products. So these all are the very important and very rich and major food companies in the market, like Godrej Healthy Food, health drink, soya-based product, they are just a predominantly. If you see the Patanjali, they are just functioning in retail markets, in the juice, fruit and vegetable juices, products, herbal. These all are the basically available in the market. So our country have a huge potential in the food processing sector. Next, please. Like, if you see some common functional food brand in the food processing, like Happy Dent, Chyawanprash, Hajmola, Shilajit Gold, if you see, these all are the mostly food sector. They are categorizing as functional foods. So different company were just predominantly in food brand. Happy Dent, the major ingredient, if you see the neem, pudina extract, these are the Happy Dent, Chyawanprash formulations with the number of herbs like Amola, Giloy, and more than 40 other natural ingredients. Hajmolas also have a very major ingredient like black pepper, black salt. My purpose is to say everywhere this food processing play a very important role, from including the natural or the raw ingredient to the final product. This food processing is very important. That's why a proper food processing is essential for the development of proper food products. Next. So if you come to the functional food and medicine in the food processing market, most of the people are confused that this is the food or this is the medicine. So if you come to the different parameter of the functional medicine and mode of action. In case of functional foods, they modulate up the physiological process within the normal range. It means agar aapko bimari ho gayi to they never treat, but when you use continuously you will just avoid to the disease. Medicines, the modulation of a physiological process outside the normal range means your physiological disturbances goes beyond the limit. In that cases medicine is effective. That is the one of the attitudes. The purpose of functional food to enhance normal function in order to optimize health, well-being and performance, to reduce risk factor for disease. In case of the medicine, the purpose is to treat or prevent disease and to enhance performance beyond normal range. Means when the things in the beyond the normal range, your functional food will be effective. Below the normal range, when the beyond the normal range, medicine will be effective. Means if you take the functional foods continuously, it will act as medicine for after a longer duration. So if you see the functional food, most of the functional food we take in the form of food consumed as a part of normal diet. But in case of medicine, we take pill, tablets, capsules, syrup. These all are the format for the medicines. Next, ma'am, please. So these are the prospecting, these are the scope, these are the sectors where food processing industries are predominant. But there are a huge competition of food processing sector. If you see this slide, if you see several names, several brand names, and these, most of these brands names are just developing in similar types of products. So the entering in this food processing sector required a huge amount of work. Like if you see everywhere, all these names are a brand name. All these names are the major players in food processing sectors. So what are the different competition in food processing sector? Next, ma'am. Next, please. If you see, come to the food processing and dairy processing. Most of the dairy processing dominated in some regions like Gujarat, Karnataka, Maharashtra, Tamil. These are the regions where dairy in processing is predominant. In this sector, in this region, Amul and Nandini is very much important. In cases of Gujarat cooperative, 26% of this India market shared by the liquid food, which is by the Amul. Nandini is also in Karnataka cooperative. If you see, these are the some major players which are doing an important role in the dairy processing. So these players are mostly involved in the major economy of the food processing in this region. Next, please. If you see, these are the some company and their major products in the dairy sector, like Gujarat Cooperative, Amul, Karnataka Cooperative, Nandini, National Dairy, National Board, Mother Dairy, Nestle, Hull and Danone. If you see, these all are the in this country and some of the other country in collaborated things. So if you come to the fruit and vegetable processing, again these sectors are mainly include the jam, juice, pickles, chutney and fruit concentrated. And this fruit and vegetable market are highly unorganized. They are very their requirement of organization of this sector, because of the local farmers, wholesaler and intermediate selling directly to the consumers. Although some rules in this times also formulated, but these sectors are highly organized. So the processed fruit and vegetable market is organized with the presence of some national and international players also. So with the potential to become one of the largest producer of food and processing, coupled with the assembly low levels of processing, most of the Indians offer huge potential for the international. That's why most of the international players comes in our country. Next, ma'am. So this is again some of the company which has involved in the food processing sector, like Hull, Mother Dairy, Priya Foods, Ceramics, Nandini Fresh, Nandini Agri Fresh. So these are the major products in the market, like jams, ketchup, sauce, frozen. Everywhere, if you see, these are the scopes and these are the market of the vegetable processing in current scenario. Next, ma'am, please. So if you come to the meat, poultry and marine, this is again a highly fragmented sector. And only a handful of large players, means only few players are in the market. So this have again a very important field, important processing sector, which can be useful to the coming entrepreneur and industry. In this sector, mostly Uttar Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, Maharashtra, Delhi are the key area are processed in this region. So within this industry, poultry is again very fast growing segment. So we can just use this sectors for the in different sector, one of maybe the strong domestic consumption. As if you see, as Arabian and Western cousins expand in India, demands these sectors, this area is very high. So they have again a very important scopes in this current scenario. Next. So these are the some company and these are their major products in this sector. Next, ma'am. So if you come to the grain and seeds, these grain processing include milling of rice, wheat and pulses, seed processing, and also including extraction of oil or edible and industrial purpose. So this is very highly fragmented industry sector in nowadays. So thousands of rice sellers, flours, mills are available, but there is not a high coordination. That's why competition in this MS segment is intense. Means once places, the person is highly concentrated in other places, this is vacant. That's why this is again largest agriculture based sector. So this sector can be very much useful if you organize properly. Although the primary processing is important activity in this grain and seed processing sector, but secondary and tertiary processing is also limited in few large players. So we can utilize this grain processing sector in primary, secondary and tertiary, and finally goes to the very market based or demanding food products. Next, man. These are the some companies which are the involved, which are the related to the this grain industry, like Hull, Kellogg's, ITC. And if you see, these are the very big names. Means competition is also there, and these big names are just have a major products like wheat flours, oats, bran wheat flours, wheat flours. If you see these edibles, oil flour, these are very much predominant in our market. So this sector is again very important for the new coming entrepreneurs or the industry purpose. One thing is important, how can we organize, how can you develop the different mode of product, that is the important. Next. Next, ma'am, please. So if you come to the why these consumer foods have the competition in the food processing, if you see, the consumer food is a highly competitive industry in the India with the preference of large national and international companies. If you see the Britannia, Parley and ITG, they mainly capture 90% share of the biscuit industry. Means most of the biscuit processing industry is just shared by the this major player. If you come to the Perfect Thai, the 70% market share is confectionery shared by Perfect Thai. Nestle with the Maggi brand is again a market leader of the noodle segment. If you come to the Coca-Cola and Pepsi, over 90% market share in aerated beverage segment. That's why if you come to the ready to eat or ready to cook products, the competition between the competition against these major players is important. That's why we, our formulations, our development, the shelf life and storage, all property of developed products become important when come in compared to this industry. Next. Next, ma'am. Please, next. So, and these are the, if you see, these all have the brands and these are the major products. That's why if you want to enter this sector, you must be care of these branded companies for your success of your processing. Next. Next. So competition is high, but this sector have challenges is also high, but the opportunities in food processing sector is also very high. So the role of government is very much important. If any person either working in the processing sector or they just think about the processing sector. So Ministry of Food Processing has taken several initiatives to promote the growth of this food processing industry by several incentive like tax relief, relaxed FDI farm. In case of tax relief, they just relief from the several tax. If you see the descriptions, that they prefer 100% tax exemption for the first 5 years, preferred tax exemption for the companies operating in perishable foods, item like milk, meat, and investment-linked tax incentive, full excise duty exemption for the good for debt distribution of cold storage facility. Means these are the very good thing, a very important initiative taken by the government of India to just boost this food processing sector. So these are very important, and Ministry of Food Processing are also just taking care of this all the things for the promotion of this. Relax FDI form 100% FDI under automatic routes except for the item reserved for micro, small and medium enterprises. So these are the some of the important factors, some of the conditions from the government side, which will be very useful to this establishing this food processing sector. Next. Next, ma'am, please. Next. Next. Ma'am is here. Okay. So these are the some focused on infrastructure push for R&D private sector. All are the very good initiative. If you see everywhere, this market of the food processing will be enhanced. Like a strong focus on the infrastructure development, particularly the government is have planned to are already established mega food parks, agri export zones, cold chains, warehouse, and modernization of the laboratories. Push for the R&D. They also just taking care of the R&D. They just waited reduction in expenditure input on the household R&D has been increased also. They just try to waitage the deduction of payment mode of R&D labor is increased this. And private sector, if you see, this is the normal condition, but this is the COVID time. And during COVID time, most of the this policy and most of the this condition is not as before COVID. So this is the standard incentive for FDI. In presently, the government is also promoting the food processing sector at different village level, at ground level, at industry level. Next. Next, ma'am. So, and these are the several agreement also joined by the India for the promotion of the this. If you see, the India is a member of more than 65 international organizations. They are working with the, or they are just supporting to the such types of industry like ADB, BRICS, ASEAN, FAO, ICC, MFO. So these all are the organizations which are the also very serious to the this food processing sector. Next. Next. Okay. And just I am coming to the conclusions. Please, what is the action for the post-COVID-19? Because this food processing sector, not only food processing sector, but other sectors, every sectors are the just affected. But food processing sector, we have already discussed that the food is the only options which can utilized nowadays to the prevent ourselves from the COVID-19. So this action plan for the post COVID-19 is very important, and we have plans. We have just suggestions for some plans, like adopted newer changes, like bring some policy decision and help this sector grow, which will sustain farming sector of the India. Government declares food processing sector as the extension of the agriculture sector and makes it free of all license and GST requirement. That is the problem for the establishing a newcomers. Encourage farmer to the go for the processing, because most of the food process raw ingredient comes from the farmer. So it is need to initiate the farmers levels. Farmer processed produce can be brought to the market directly. That this is the one of the major problem where the farmers either process their product, but the transport, but the demand is not up to the level. The ministry can bring some incentive for the R&D organization to the boost this R&D sectors. All government sector scheme should be more practical and most effective to the COVID-19. Next, ma'am. I think this is the conclusion. So we come to the conclusion. If you see, India is one of the largest food producers in the world and offer vast opportunities to food processing company. Its priority sector status and significant support from the government, basically setting for the mega food packs, make it a very attractive sector for the investment. Food processing sector has huge potential to come back and also support farmers. And thus the proper planning and policy interventions, India can become kitchen of the world. Post-COVID-19 and food processing sector grow and over 25% annual growth in the next 2 years. This we hope by taking this consideration. So if you take proper care, if you use the proper intensely, definitely once times come when our logo, which is the survey sukhai, comes at the ground level, and our food processing sector become one of the important processing sector for the economy as well as food for everyone. And we will also, and this will be also helpful to overcome COVID-like problems, which is the fearing, which is the fear us for the future. Next. And thank you. And thank you. I am also joined with my mobile view where video is just looking. So thank you, and you all are the invited to any query and anything.
Any questions, please?
Thank you for the wonderful presentation, sir. My name is Ronak. My question is regarding the regulatory bodies in the food processing sector.
Actually, sir, all the regulatory bodies like FSSAI is directly related to this. And during the norms for the development and safety, everything is gone by the FSSAI. But wherever we make the any formulations or any standard, BIS is also involved in this sector. So everyone, FSSAI, BIS and food processing sectors are very much involved and serious to this food sector, especially in food processing sector, sir. And we have all the details. If you're interested, I will send this thing.
Sure, sir. Thank you so much.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, please.
Sir, as a food and grains storage processing, sir, suggest me some government initiative schemes about the warehouse making.
Sir, this is the big thing. And I have some information with the details. And you just take my email ID. I will share all these documents. Because there are several levels, like state level, food processing level, some central governments, some initiatives are they just taken. So I will share all this information regarding this establishing this such types of.
Okay, thank you so much, sir.
You all are welcome, and to just join this COVID-19 programs. And try to manage yourself by taking such immune boosting and other foods, because this is the one alternative. And I will share my one of the papers which is published before one day in the Springer Nature, which is very much useful to the what are the nutritional aspect, how can we improve our immunity using nutritional, and at home how can we overcome this problem. Okay.
Any other questions, please? Any other question?
And ma'am, I am very sorry because my video is not working, and we cannot interact directly. That's why we use my mobile cluster.